Back to Shine TV. It is me, Jazlyn Shine. Welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much if you've watched any of my past videos. Thank you if you commented, liked, subscribed, especially. Thank you so much for the support. So this video today is going to be how I got into crystals. That's what it's going to be about. And if you're interested in that, just stay tuned and we can get right into it. So if you're tuned in, I'm assuming that you want to know how I got into crystals and self-healing and being into the whole self-love thing. I actually got into crystals and self-healing in 2015. I was going through a really, 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 really bad time and I was really depressed. My ex went to prison and I didn't know how to cope with it. Like, emotionally, I was not there. Like, it was really, really a hard time for me. And I have a really, really close friend. Why do I keep saying really, really? Anyway, I have a close friend. She's into stuff like that, and so I reached out to her and I asked her about the crystals and stuff like that because for some reason at that time it was really interesting to me. And I guess it was because it was time and I was having like a spiritual awakening. And so she told me a little bit about it, but really wanted me to do my own research on it. And so that's what I did. I dove into it. I did my own research. And I ended up finding one crystal store in Atlanta that I went to first. And I probably bought one or two crystals from there, but I didn't really like the store. And then I found another one that's Phoenix and Dragons, which is my favorite. It's the one I tell everybody about. They have the best store in Atlanta if you need crystals, like any kind of books, if you're into tarot card reading, any of that kind of stuff, you can find it at Phoenix and Dragons. Like, the store is huge. So that's how I got into it. Right now I did want to show the crystals that I have with me right now in Vegas. The thing is, I only have three crystals right now, and it's because when I moved from Vegas, I have no idea where I put my old crystal. This is the only one I've had since 2015, and every time I lose it, it literally finds its way back to me. And it's a tiger's eye. And then this is just a rose quartz. I just got this one out here. I've been thinking it's not really a rose quartz because it's lost its color. And I know you have to be careful when purchasing stones and crystals and stuff from stores because some of them are knockoffs. But the vibrations from it are on point, so I'm not knocking that it's not rose quartz. And this is a moonstone, and it's just a cute little one. And I recently, at the beginning of this video, you'll see I just took a spiritual bath. Yesterday I got my first Reiki healing, so today is the second day after my Reiki, and I feel really, really good. I was really emotional yesterday, but right now I'm really, like, my energy is really, really good. I feel really positive, really happy, really excited to see what's next in life because I got a tarot card reading. So yeah, that's it. So those are my crystals. When I first got into crystals also, I purchased this book. I hope you guys can see it. It's a chakra book. It's kind of like a guide to meditation because, of course, you can ask somebody how to meditate, and it's really up to you how you want to meditate. So it's really good to do your own research and see different ways to meditate and then find which way is best for you. So, and then this is another book I've had since 2015, and it's just a crystal book, crystal energy. In it is so many, let's see how many pages. It's like maybe 150 pages of what each crystal and what each stone can do for you, from headaches to promoting self-love, reducing travel sickness. What it does is it recommends the different crystals and stones that you need if you want to solve anything, any problems you might have, or want to attract something into your life. It's just giving you those crystals and those suggestions of the crystals that you should grab. Yeah, so when I chose my crystals, I kind of did it in a way where I was drawn to the crystals. I didn't just go in the store and pick them. Like, that's not what I did. I let the crystals get my attention, and the energy kind of flowed through me, and I picked my crystals, and every time I pick the crystals, it was the one that I needed at that moment in that time in my life. And so, yeah, the crystal thing and energy healing and just being about, because energy is so real, like, and I know that it's real, and I've always known that it's real since I got into it, but I definitely know that it's real from yesterday, from my Reiki experience. I would suggest anybody go get a Reiki healing, even if you don't have, I wasn't going through anything besides stressing. I stress a lot right now, and so that's the only thing I really deal with. So if you're going through like a sickness though, you can get all of your chakras just cleansed, like, and opened, and you just will feel good about yourself at the end of the day. So I definitely encourage anybody to go ahead and do Reiki healing. That's pretty cool. Other than that, I just wanted to make this video so when I have future videos like this, you can always come back to this video and say, oh, that's how she got into it. Other than that, that's all. If you guys like this video, please give me a thumbs up. If you didn't, you can give me a thumbs down. It's fine, baby. You can comment, subscribe, everything. I'm going to respond. If you have any questions about this video, please drop the questions below. Feel free to give me, ask questions or give me your opinion on this video. It's fine. I welcome everything. Tune in to my next video next time with Jazlyn Shine. And I love you guys.